Well, Bridget Jones' Diary was the latest reading for the world's singletons. The girl who drank too much, smoked too much and was never quite at her goal weight kept us hooked with her stories of her complicated love life. By the time the sequel hit the cinemas, it looked like the hopeless romantic had finally found the one. But fast forward to today and Bridget's happily ever after hasn't gone according to plan. Bridget is back on the dating scene, but life has thrown her a bit of a curveball, as Angela Bishop found out when she sat down with the stars of Bridget Jones's Baby.
Dear Diary, it's sort of a funny story. A few months ago, I met Jack.
So it lasted 6 hours.
What lasted 6 hours?
A puppet show that Auntie Bridge went to.
Patrick, Renee, what a joy to see you both today.
Thank you.
I sat with a very happy crowd of people last night and watched the movie.
Oh, wow.
So congratulations.
Nice.
Thank you.
Really loved it.
Renee, it's great to have you back in the role. Did you um and ah about it, or is she just so special to you that you were ready for another run?
Immediate yes. No brainer. I read the script and I just love being back with her family and her friends and in her world. It just reminded me how much I love this character, and then when they mentioned this guy, I thought, you know, maybe we should do that movie.
Seriously, it's been 5 years since you broke up with Mark. What you need is some sex.
Ding dong.
I'm a huge motorsport fan, so I love that you do all of that sort of stuff.
And what type of racing do you like?
Well, I love Formula One, is my passion. Sure. But we have a race track here called Bathurst.
Yes, of course.
Have you done it?
I have not.
Is it on your bucket list?
It would be something I'd love to do.
What car would you do on it?
I'm with Porsche, so I'd have to be with Porsche, of
and
course.
I reckon that would be perfect.
Yeah, I mean, I would love to do the big cars, you know. I'd love to go and test with one of the teams, certainly.
Can we come watch?
Yeah, yes. You should get in the car.
Do you like
you'd love it.
Do you like fast cars, Renee?
Yes,
like,
ma'am.
You like the
what
smell of petrol in the morning?
And my love life is showing signs of improvement.
Oh. May I?
It fits.
Renee, you've got your extended family here.
I do.
Have you had a chance to catch up with anyone?
Yes, right away. Planned everything around meeting up with the Rellos. So, yes, they've been coming along. They were there last night at screening. We had a nice meal. And
thought I heard some really loud cheers from right behind me.
Thank you, family. Represent.
Hard news going live in 10.
You always try online dating again.
6.
The other night I was on Tinder.
4.
Half an hour later, I'm having a three-way with
Hugh.
Prince Andrew has just written his first children's book.
You did that on purpose.
When we were researching and going down to the studio to see how it all works, I mean, I had absolutely no idea. I mean, every moment, there is potential for catastrophic disaster.
Correct.
And everybody's so cool and calm about it, but, you know, you're losing time and you've got live feed to cut away and the script is there, but then it gets switched around at every second. And
you feel our pain.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then you get the verbose actor who sits on the couch and, you know, you're trying to make up, like, you're missing a minute, you gotta make it up, and then I promised I would never be verbose on morning television again, and here I am.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Renee, one of the roles I loved you in most, and there have been many, was in Chicago. I'm mesmerised. I watch it again and again and again.
Oh,
it's one of my favourite films.
Thank you.
Are you going to sing and dance again? Is that something you think of doing again?
Every day in my shower.
But you're better than shower worthy,
madam.
You're in the best film
sweet.
Of that year, Oscar winning film.
That's so nice. Thank you. That was a dream come true. Never imagined being part of something like that. And it was such a gift. Such a gift. And the friendships that I made, I kept.
Would you do it again?
Oh, in a minute. Yeah.
Can't go back and keep making same mistakes.
I'm pregnant.
When I can make new ones.
So lovely to talk to you both.
Nice
Thank you.
Too.
Welcome home.
Are we going to go and watch him do the test drive?
I think we are.
Think we
you
should.
Me, Bathurst, will be
do
on the
sidelines. Do you race yourself? Do you drive?
I've raced in 3 races. I did the IndyCar Celeb Race, the Grand Prix Celeb Race, and a V8
How
Supercar
did
Celeb Race.
Well, what were you ever?
Best was 5th at the Indy.
That's really tough, too.
Which of you is the father?
I am.
Forward to that.
It's like putting on a comfy pair of Ugg boots, isn't it? It's getting back into Bridget's world.
Do you think she'll end up with Mr. Darcy again?
I love that she's not perfect. You know, with Instagram and everything these days, everyone's world's so perfect. I love that her, you know, she's in the mud.
Don't you mean you'd want to get back into those big underpants that Hugh Grant thought was so sexy? I mean, that was the thing I always remember about Bridget Jones.
Well, apparently she's reached her goal weight in this movie.
Well, haven't people actually been criticising the movie because she seems too happy and well balanced and
She's got a whole new set of problems though. Obviously she's pregnant to she doesn't know who.
Or to someone. Yeah. And that's the main thing.
She is gorgeous.
She is.